My name's Bill Scavala. I'm kind of the, I don't know, I guess the leader, the team leader for the Asian Longhorn Beetle Citizens Cooperative. I'm also the guy unfortunate enough to have found his damn beetle in my yard. So things have gone downhill since then. I just want to give you a couple little heads up things about what has been going on here in Bethel. The government still, they insist that the best way to get rid of this beetle is to take out all the trees that could potentially hold a beetle in the future. So my organization is essentially saying you just can't do that. You can't do that to Bethel. You can't do it to Tate Township. You can't do it to Southwest Ohio. So I'll give you an example. If they get away with what they want to do, this pretty, this beautiful ash tree, this sweet gum will stay, but the one next to it, that ash tree, that'll go. That ash tree at the top of the hill will go. This white sycamore over here will go. The sycamore on the other side of the stage will go. Those are all trees that could potentially hold a beetle someday. They may not have beetles in them now. We know they don't have beetles in them now, but they're going to go anyways just because of one tree in the village of Bethel that might have been found to have an infestation in it. So this is what we're all about. We're saying, hey, you know what? Please, let's try to save as many trees as we possibly can in Bethel. Let's try to encourage the government to treat them just like they've done in so many other infestations throughout this country. We're now the fifth in the United States, and we're the only one that they have refused to treat the trees so far. Tim Back's up there from Back Tree Service. He can explain to you the whole process about trunk injection and how that whole thing works and why it's safe for the environment and everything else. I want to thank our major sponsors before I go any further. Community Savings Bank, John Essen and Judy Adams and the gangs up there at the top of the driveway. They've contributed a total of $10,000 to our organization to try to save as many trees in Bethel as they possibly can. They really need to have a hand. So if you go by that table up there, make sure you tell them you appreciate what they've done for us. Second major sponsor, I gotta mention the Village of Bethel. They've given us the use of the stage and the use of the park and everything on their tab. And I just love Bethel. I would live nowhere else in the world. I just love it here, and they'll bury my ass in that vineyard over there. The third thing that I wanted to mention is that we have this auction coming. Oh, no, wait. I've got another major vendor. Oh, Loud and Clear, the guys that did all the staging system behind me. Bill Devers and that whole gang, the sound engineer over here under the tent. I really want to thank you guys. We finally got it worked out to get some power here at the stage. I can't get any better than this kind of music.